Hydrocephalus, in its simplest form, is too much water on the brain. In the early 50s, shunting or cerebrospinal fluid diversion was invented, and that's where we've been for the last 60 years. We now know a lot more about the injury mechanisms that occur in hydrocephalus. The group of people now at the forefront of research are combining clinical and basic research. Drug and gene therapy are really at the forefront. HANDS is the Hydrocephalus Association Network for Discovery Science.
There's a new model for how hydrocephalus may start, and there's a new way of maybe being able to treat hydrocephalus. Overall, throughout the country, hydrocephalus is about a third of the overall practice of pediatric neurosurgery, so it's the most common thing that we do. It affects about 1 in 1,000 children. It's a very common condition. Obviously, it's not well known, so when we're in the operating room and we see various forms of hydrocephalus, if you're inquisitive, you want to try to understand why this hydrocephalus is developing, and is there a way to better understand or better treat hydrocephalus.
I just want to give you a flavor for what it's like to work in a lab and to find key results in hydrocephalus. We focused on a specific fat, a lipid, in particular a specific form called lysophosphatidic acid, or LPA. Blocking the LPA1 receptor in a fetus allows us to prevent LPA or blood-induced hydrocephalus. It's this very big wow moment for us. Having this HANDS discovery network allowed me to talk with other hydrocephalus investigators, share biospecimens, share results. This has jump-started and accelerated our research.
My lab is a developmental neuroscience lab. We're looking at how the brain forms, how the ventricles form. We also want to try to find strategies for ways to rescue or prevent hydrocephalus. The models have led to some significant discoveries in how hydrocephalus starts in the developing brain, what cells are responsible for it, and what pathways, molecular pathways and targets, specifically genes and molecular pathways, are involved. And now the Hydrocephalus Association support has allowed us to mature that to do really good science, really digging deep into the mechanisms behind how hydrocephalus forms and how we'd be able to treat that. It's not one particular condition, it's a set of conditions that we're trying to understand and actually molecularly subclassify with our genetics work. Hopefully at the end of this, we'll be able to come up with a medication that's targeted to a very individual, or an individual's case of hydrocephalus, and I think that's the goal.
It's been 30 years since any studies have ever been done on what types of cells grow in and block shunts. We're providing shunts that have come out of patients because they were blocked, sending them to Detroit. If we identify the types of cells, then we can target the coatings on the catheters or other drug attempts to try to prevent shunt obstruction. What we're doing will help people at all ages, even though the ones that already have hydrocephalus.
Science these days isn't about working in an isolated lab. It's about drawing expertise from lots of different areas. This type of collaborative, open research leads to major breakthroughs, and it's no different for hydrocephalus.
We've been able to take our innovative ideas and recruit some of the top scientists in these areas and convince them that hydrocephalus is important. We're collaborating with groups in Boston, Seattle, here in the Midwest, the leading institutions, and all because of the Hydrocephalus Association support. If you don't start by looking at basic science related to hydrocephalus, you're never going to get to the point where there's going to be a medication. We have a patient who's undergone, you know, close to 100 something surgeries for hydrocephalus because it's, you know, been complicated in its various forms. And, you know, your heart goes out to each one of these families that's affected. It's my goal, and that's why I take it very seriously with the HA support, that we're trying to find a cure.
Research takes time. It takes a lot of going down blind alleys, and by providing key resources, funding for scientists like us to go after these key steps, you're really making a concrete contribution to the eventual goal of curing hydrocephalus.